Today you'll be learning how to factorize an algebraic expression. The given algebraic expression is 5x plus 20. To do so, we first find the highest common factor of 5x and 20. The highest common factor of 5x and 20, what we get is 5. So we take 5 common here and then we divide 5x by 5 and get x as the quotient, and 20 we divided by 5 to get 4 as the quotient. So x plus 4 and 5 are the two factors of the algebraic expression 5x plus 20. The second example which we are going to do today is 14m minus 21. Now if we find the HCF of 14m and 21, we get 7 as the HCF. So we take 7 here and then we divide 14m by 7 to get 2m as the quotient, and we divide 21 by 7 to get 3 as the quotient. So 2m minus 3 and 7 are the factors of 14m minus 21. The third example is slightly different. It has variable term, that is n, in both the terms. Like you have 9n minus 12n square. So nothing to worry. Here, when we find the HCF, we get HCF as 3n. That is, the HCF of 9n and 12n square is 3n. So we take 3n here and then we divide 9n by 3n to get 3 as the quotient, and we divide 12n square by 3n to get 4n as the quotient. So 3n times 3 minus 4n are the factors of 9n minus 12n square. In the fourth example, we have 3abc plus 42a square b square c cube. So here we get the HCF as 3abc, and then when we factorize, we get the factors as 3abc times 1 plus 14abc square. Now in the fifth example, we have three terms, so this is a trinomial. So let's see how to factorize this polynomial. Now again we go about finding out the HCF of all these three terms, that is 6n square m minus 12nm and then 27n square m square. So we get the HCF as 3nm. So we take the HCF here and then we divide 6n square m by 3n to get a 2n, and then we divide 12nm by 3nm and we get a 4, and then we divide 27n square m square by 3nm and we get a 9nm. So the factors of the above polynomial are 3nm times, in the brackets, 2n minus 4 plus 9nm. We move on to the sixth one. Now this is slightly a different one. Here you can see the polynomial as 2a times x plus y minus 3b times x plus y. Now when we find the HCF of these two terms, we get the HCF as x plus y, as x plus y is common to those two terms. So we take x plus y here and we divide 2a times x plus y by x plus y, so we get 2a as the quotient, and we divide 3b x plus y by x plus y to get 3b as the quotient. So then the factors of this example number 6 are x plus y times 2a minus 3b.